What's up everyone, how are y'all doing? Welcome in another episode on how to make a raft. This time it's gonna be a big taming raft. You can tame almost everything in here, almost. Because I mean, you cannot tame here a giga or bronto. Most probably you will be able to tame Quetzal if you are lucky to get him on it. For the rest, let me show you how it looks like, and later on I'm gonna break it and make it again for you to show you simply how to make it. Like you see, you can also keep a wyvern in here and stuff, not a big problem. Though she's sticking out, you can still keep it. Now, the biggest issue about it is when you finish it up, you cannot place any more ladders. The best way to have it is when you have tech, some flying device, or simply you're flying all the time with some griffin or something like this. Now, let me get off the wire. As you see, I have NPC mode, so random NPCs are building up some funny things around and shooting good. So when you start playing on my server, you gotta watch out on them. They are actually really dangerous. Let's eat their house. For trying to eat me. Let's see what's happening. That's, by the way, spawned. Wyvern. I didn't really hatch it or catch it. I simply summoned it. So let's get to the build. Oops. A bit too far. No. Gonna demolish first to show you how to make it. A lot of darkness. Surprise. I wish I could skip it, but it's kinda live recording, so that can be difficult. Let's break down parts. Let's get everything back to normal. me show you one trick with the foundations and ceilings. Clean raft, it's quite straight, surprisingly. Now let me show you how to do it. First thing you want to do is place touch ceilings around it. And just one row of extension, that's enough. The second thing you want to do is place foundations under those thatch ceilings. It's very important that those ceilings are thatched, otherwise you won't be able to place foundations under it. Should leave one space for hatch frame. Now you can remove ceilings to spare slots on your platform. Place a hatch frame, actually without the door. They are unnecessary. Now another step that you want to make, actually what I forgot to do, you actually want to keep one hatch frame so you can extend your level down. But I do have it already. Okay. Now you would like to extend the wall by placing 5 walls. Okay. Next step. This giant hatch frame. We can get rid of those two. Now the reason you're placing 5 is because you cannot place the giant hatch frame totally on the bottom side of the fifth one. You can place it only a level up, so now you can demolish it and place the rest of the hatch frames along with the door. Thank you. let's start with the diamond gates. Now you may do it perfectly, you can do it actually the way you want. It doesn't really matter as long as it's sealed and it doesn't show any spaces. I'm not gonna do it perfectly because I want to do it fast to show you the concept itself, so later on you can do it by yourself easily. Now you may have a problem with placing a dino gate over here, so what you want to do is place the rest of the door and then move this wall over here. Simply build another four pieces. Since you already have it, you can remove this one. Since we have already a bottom part, we can move up to the higher part. Now, since we already done with the lower, we can remove this by placing foundation under it first and then removing the ceiling. This is finished. Now let's go up. Next steps you want to do is placing dino gates around again. So it's a little bit like repeating the steps of lower level, where you can keep your water tanks. Not easy. Keep it in mind that you don't want it to snap to other dino gate. You want it to freely be placed on a separate slot, on a separate placing. So not like this, because this will snap, but something more like this, so it blends in. Otherwise, if one of them goes down, all of them will go. Even if you try to fix something by removing it, you will remove all of them in one time. And that's pretty much frustrating, because you won't get back even the metal from the rest. Now, since we have already the second level, if you want, you might finish on this level, of course, by placing another four walls. And a giant hatch frame on top. With the door. And this is pretty much finished, the second floor. Or second level, sorry. Or actually a first level above the sea level. Now let's get to a second level. Of course the same way like the others. And the last step are doors. So this is pretty much finished concept. I don't believe you can place anything more. It has structure limits. It's too much parts already. But this is really useful for keeping tames, same as above water, flyers. Underwater tames, anything you pretty much imagine is smaller than Bronto or Quetzal, because Quetzal cannot really land on it unless you build it in a special way, which I will also show how to land a Quetzal with a platform on another platform. Thank you guys for watching, thank you for listening, subscribe, like, leave a comment, tell me what you think about it, tell me what you want me to change or what to do, so it will be much more fun for both of us, and thank you very much, bye bye.